It's Tom Green Live. Live from Los Angeles. Tonight's special guest, Carrot Top.
Welcome to the show. We are live. This is exciting. Well, actually, you know what? We're live. We are live. It is a live show. It's a live television show. And unless, of course, you're watching a rerun. You could be watching a rerun, then we would not be live. But right now, it is live, if this is the live broadcast. If it's not the live broadcast and it's airing later, then it's the rerun. That's how it works. There's no real way to tell whether or not it's a rerun or not, or whether it's live or not, unless, well, I guess there is. It's Thursday. It's Thursday right now. If it's Thursday, it's probably live, because it reruns on other days. Anyways, let's forget about that. Let's just assume it's live, okay? Because it is live. It's being taped live, and we're excited about it. We've got Carrot Top on the show today, and this is going to be a great show. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. This is just the way the show starts every week. You know, I just, you know, we want to have fun around here. I want to start out by thanking all of you for tuning in every week. It's important that you watch every week, because there's an ongoing storyline that goes from episode to episode to episode. Last week on the show, I hiked up to the top of the Hollywood sign hills, and I came back with this rock. And we decided to have our first contest on the show. Yeah, you don't have to clap, really. It's just a, well, it's exciting, right?
Yeah.
That was one of those moments where it seemed like it was, to me, maybe I was the only one in the room excited about it or something. We're having our first contest on the show. The contest is you can win this piece of Hollywood, all right? So what we're going to do is we're going to go to Twitter now. We've asked people watching the show last week to tweet me at Tom Green Live, and we had a flood of tweets. Hundreds of tweets came in from people saying they want this piece of Hollywood. Here, let's read some of the tweets now. From Luca Troni, at Luca Troni, is the rock still up for grabs? I'm a geology student, and I think a sedimentary rock signed by Tom Green might save my GPA. Probably not. We got lots of tweets. That's the thing I wanted to explain to you guys, too, by the way, watching the show, is we're live here every Thursday night, but then throughout the week, I'm live on Twitter every day. It's my personal Twitter, at Tom Green Live. I read all the tweets. I'm very interactive on there, and we're having a lot of fun with all of you guys that are participating. Let's read another tweet from somebody. I want that rock. This is from Duckman32. I want that rock. I'm going to smother it with barbecue sauce and unconditional love. Right? That's funny, right? That's funny. We're trying to encourage people to write funny tweets, and the winner gets the rock. The winner gets the rock. Let's read another tweet right now. I know, this is from at Craig underscore Ed. I know why I want it now. I want someone to throw it at me and see if it hurts while wearing my cheese helmet. Right? From my movie Freddy Got Fingered. Cheese helmet. That's from my movie. It's from my movie Freddy Got Fingered. So let's read our last tweet here, okay? From Brett underscore Owen 99. I don't even want the rock. Who cares about a rock? Hashtag reverse psychology. Huh? Should that one win? Maybe that one should win.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so. Let's give it to him. Do we have someone else? Let's read one more tweet. New Jersey, this is from at MeatwadNJ. At MeatwadNJ. New Jersey needs the rock. The rock will reverse the polar vortex we are currently experiencing. It will balance the Earth's axis. Okay? I don't know if that's true, but what do you say? Who should win? That one? Meatwad? I think we should give it to Meatwad, just because he used the word axis in his tweet. We're going to send it to you, Meatwad. We're going to contact you on Twitter. We're going to get your information. We're going to FedEx this piece of Hollywood to you. And we'd like it if you could make a video of where you place the rock in your home and send it back to us. What else is going on? Last week, if you watched the show, and you have to watch it every week, we bought my new 1979 Z28 Camaro. It broke down immediately after I bought it on the 405 freeway. We brought it to the shop. It was in the shop for a few days. We got all the liquids and oils changed. We got all the batteries and things checked. And we got it back on the road. And we're going to take you on an adventure every week. We got it back on the road. And the wheel fell off. Okay, here's a shot to prove. See how there's five nuts normally hold that wheel on? And there was only one nut left. See, the four nuts broke right off and the wheel almost fell right off the thing and we could have been killed. But we're gonna have a lot of fun. We're gonna take you on adventures on this. Look at that. One nut holding that thing on. You can do fine with one nut, by the way. All you need is one. All you need is one. But we're gonna have fun with this thing and we're gonna take you on an adventure every week here around Los Angeles. It's the Z28 Camaro. You see, it's got leather seats. It's in great condition. It's got a speedometer and an unworking lighter and a cassette deck. There's the cassette. We're going to be listening to some cassettes and driving around Los Angeles and taking on you on a little tour of the city. It's kind of going to be like that show, Seinfeld's Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee, except our car doesn't work. It's like that show. That show is a good show, by the way. Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee. You should watch it. It's an internet show.
That's a sweet-ass ride.
It is. Yeah, this nice guy we met in the street here.
79 Camaro.
79? Wow.
It's a sweet-ass ride right there. That's a good show, though, that Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee. It's an internet show. It's not a TV show. But, here we go. Hollywood High. This is one of the first places we wanted to show you on our little trip around Los Angeles each week. Cher went to this high school. John Ritter, Sarah Jessica Parker, Brandy. There I am pointing at it. Every week I will point at something. Judy Garland went to that high school. Carol Burnett went to that high school. There I am pointing at another building. That is Ennis House. That was built by famed architect Frank Lloyd Wright. It's a beautiful building. We wanted to show it to you up close. You don't normally see this on TV. This was where they filmed Blade Runner.
I'm gonna go with this new look.
That's my new hair, okay? That's my new hair for the new season. We're thinking of doing this as well. That's another thing we're gonna do on our advent. Oh boy. Let's just look at this for a sec. It's the Ted Koppel look. And I don't know. I don't know what kind of show this is all of a sudden. I'm not. I guess the idea is we just want to shoot a little video every week. We're going to drive around in the Z28. We're going to shoot a little video. We're going to show you some video clips from around Los Angeles. Because I've been living in Los Angeles for 14 years now. And I remember when I moved here from Canada, I looked around and I said, well, this isn't really what I pictured Los Angeles to be like. It wasn't really, it's just a lot of grit to it. There's a seedy underbelly that you don't see. And we want to show that to you. So tune in every week. We're going to have more fun, more contests. We got a great show tonight. Carrot Top is here for the hour, taking your calls on Skype. Stick around. We'll be right back with the amazing, legendary, incredible Carrot Top. We'll be right back. Having some delicious water, Carrot Top?
Out of a Tom Green mug.
Oh, yeah, isn't that nice? We got our own mugs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is a. You've Carrot Top is here, everybody.
Thank
this
you,
is
everybody.
Amazing.
Yeah, settle down. Yeah. We'll get to that.
Yeah, you know.
These are comfortable chairs. This is like, look, you're literally like you're in a NASCAR, right? Yeah. You can't move.
We got them. We got them special for the
and
show.
And thanks for having me on a rerun. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thank
well,
you.
You know.
This is good.
This is awesome. We've been wanting to have you on the show since we started.
Yeah, we've been,
We are friends in real life.
We are indeed.
We know each other from just the last couple of years we got to know each other.
Yeah.
When we did a movie together. We have a clip. We'll show a clip of the movie
good.
Later.
Yeah, I'm excited about it. You know, then the script, it wasn't you, it was Tom Arnold.
Oh, yeah, that's
and
right.
And so I remember reading the script thinking I'm going to be doing the scene with Tom Arnold, and I got to this, they didn't know until I landed in Canada.
Oh, really?
And they said, we're just waiting for Tom. And I said, I haven't seen Tom in a long time. And then literally they said, Tom Green. I said, Tom Green. And they said, Tom Green is Tom Arnold.
Call your agent and head for the airport?
I was a little panicked. I was like, I don't know you. I knew Tom Arnold. So I didn't know if we would get along or it'd be fun, but we had a great time.
Oh, yeah, it was exciting. We have a ridiculous the fight scene clip. I want to show that a little bit. It's a movie with the Trailer Park Boys. And
brilliant.
But this is awesome to have you here, because
Thank
we wanted
you.
To have you here since. But you're busy in Las Vegas.
I am. Yeah.
Performing at the Luxor
every night.
At the Luxor.
Well, not now, not tonight, but every night. But tonight, yes.
How did that come about? How did you start playing
the first time,
at the Luxor?
Well, the first time I got the gig believe it or not, I was on Regis and Kathy Lee. That's what goes way back. And I guess I'd done the show, and I came off, and her manager, I should find his name and thank him, but he came over and said, "Hey, kid, you be good in Vegas." And I said, "Never played Vegas." And he said, "Well, you got to play Vegas." So he put me in at Bally's, where I guess they played. And it was horrible. It was the worst experience of my life. I was this room. It was a room like 4,000 seats. And I had one little trunk, and I remember thinking, I gotta go get like lava lamps and go get like furniture, like fill up the stage. So I just had all these trunks. It looks like I had more stuff than I had, and it was like 100 people or whatever it was in a 4,000 seat theater, and it was.
Had you been touring?
I did colleges, and the colleges were all drunk, like fucking caretaker. Can you cuss in this? Sorry.
Yeah, you can swear.
They're like caretaker bongs, and they love me. And then I go to Vegas, and these people are in breathing machines, and they're walking. It wasn't like they said, "Let's go see Carrot Top."
But the show's not like
we're
that.
We're gonna go see whatever's near the buffet that they're, say like a side. George Carlin used to tell me that.
Yeah.
That they don't really specifically go to see. Sometimes now that I think people know me more, they might take a trip down to see me.
George Carlin told you that.
George Carlin told me a few things, actually.
When you were hanging around with George Carlin.
I wasn't hanging out with George Carlin. I was doing a TV show, and he was on it. And he came over, and we became friends. And so he gave me a couple things of advice.
Isn't that amazing? You've got to meet George Carlin.
Yeah, it was brilliant. It was one of those moments where you just, it's surreal. It's a comic, and you get to meet one of your like this.
And now you are literally.
No, it's like this.
Now you're literally one of the most successful comedians in all of history.
In all of history? Yeah, okay.
Really?
Well, no, I've been lucky to do it for as long as I have, for sure. Definitely.
Do you think about that sometimes?
I do every day, actually. I didn't know when it first started, because everyone was going to say, this guy's out of here.
But so the idea of having a nightly show in Las Vegas where you don't have to tour, have your...
It's pretty cool.
That's just unheard of.
Yeah, it is great. It's very rare. And I've been lucky to have that for as long as I have. Yeah, I did 18, 20 years.
Now, when you started doing stand-up, do you always use props?
No, I didn't have props. I just had I had a few just jokes like, hey, I think I said I look like the Wendy's girl or something stupid, I'm pulling to Wendy's and like, oh my God, she's here. And that was my free bird. I was like, oh, that's my closer. I would open and close with that, because it was awesome. I could actually do it twice. and then I did some, I don't remember what it was. It was a comedy club in West Palm Beach, and they had auditions in the afternoon. And I remember coming down, and I did all my college jokes that were hilarious at the college. But I got done, and she's like, "That you can't do that here. You have to generalize your material. You can't just talk about being at school." So I said, "Oh, well, this sucks. Now I got to think. I don't know what to do." So I was home at in my dorm, I saw a neighborhood crime watch sign, and I thought it would be funny if I took it, because it says neighborhood crime watch. And so I took the sign, and I said, "How good is the crime watch?" And I'm watching their sign.
Yeah, if you'd actually steal the
sign. Yeah, it took an hour to unbolt the sign. It takes 20 seconds to go through a window. So
clearly
I was like,
no,
how good is
attention.
Fucking neighborhood crime watch?
Yeah.
So that was my big, I opened with it. I said, "Sorry, I'm late. I was in the neighborhood." And everybody's like, it's bruh. So I came off, and she said, "Do you have any more signs?" And I said, "No." She's like, "Well, if you could come up with more signs." So I came up with all these signs. It was almost like a slideshow of signs that were silly. And then she said, "I think the visual thing is working for you, if you had any more." But I don't know what that meant. I wasn't a prop comic. So I just started thinking of visual things. Like, old people driving in Florida you couldn't see their head. So I made a hat with an old lady's head on a spring, so when the old people drive, you could see them, and they was like, "Oh my God, now we're onto something." So I had the signs, and I had that. And so she's like, "If you could come up with like 20 more, you could." So I literally, the more shit I built, the longer I could do.
Had you ever
it was literally
seen
like
any...
I became a headliner by just making more shit.
Had you ever seen anybody doing prop shows before like that?
Naturally, growing up, seeing Rip Taylor or Gallagher or those guys, but I never really studied the prop comedy. I really didn't know what that meant. I did my own take on what I thought was. I was trying to come up with a more creative spin on things as opposed to puns. So instead of saying like, "Hey, I got a shoehorn," Uh-huh. That would be a pun. It's a shoe and a horn. So I tried to come up with stuff that was a little more out there that wasn't necessarily planned words.
We're going to look at...
we
thank
are
you
not
for
gonna look at
bringing
anything.
Some of the props.
Yeah. I brought some stuff. So exciting. You can hear them and they're like...
Yeah. Rawr. I can't wait to... Let's talk to Adam real quick in Denver,
yeah,
though.
Hi, Adam.
Real quick, Adam, before
real
our commercial
quick.
Break. Adam,
hey guys, how are you?
Go ahead with your question real quick.
All right. So, do you write all of your own material, or do you work with the team mostly?
I wish I had a team. No, I have, kids in the sweatshop. We all sit around and... No, I have a couple of people in my crew that I work off of, like anyone would do. I come in, I say, I usually know if it's somewhat funny, but I build off my crew. And I have a friend that's been helping me for years that we kind of collaborate and come up with ideas, yeah.
So you sort of visualize...
It's kind of hard to find prop writers, though. They're usually people that send me things are like, here, this is hilarious. You know, it's not... You know, I mean, you can make it hilarious, you know, whatever. It's a family show.
It's a family
show.
Really
I'm not the first
show.
Person that probably did this on the show. I'm sure Howie Mandel was like, rah, rah.
I think Howie might have done that, yeah. But now, like, do you start with, like, the physical sort of prop and then see what you can turn it into?
You'd have a topic, an idea. Like, let's say the Broncos in the Seattle whatever game. So you try to think of something that would be funny. It's in there.
Okay, great. Okay, well,
it's gonna be good too.
We're gonna dive into your tickle trunk, after the break and stick around. We'll be right back with Carrot Top.
Right.
We're back with Carrot Top, Scott Thompson. Oh, Carrot Top, yeah, sorry, he nodded off
that
there.
That was a long
bit.
Break. Whew.
Yeah, that's
man. Hope you sold some commercials.
It's calm environment
this
here.
This is the first time, by the way, I think that we've ever just communicated we're not being buzzed.
Yeah.
Because then we were in the movie.
Yeah, we like to have a few drinks.
We drank every day. We drank during the, it was the Trailer Park Boys. It was like, they didn't care.
With the Trailer Park Boys.
They can drink.
They
can hold their, yeah.
Would you like a drink?
Sure.
I have
some
of your favorite, Crown Royal.
Yeah, it's like,
what I love about,
it's like Gatorade for Canadians. I like it. It's good. Looks
Crown
good.
Royal, nice Canadian whiskey. I know it's one of your, they're one
that's
of your,
my favorite.
One
my
of your
sponsors.
Favorite. They sponsor you at your
they
show,
do,
right?
Indeed. Yeah, I give out shots of Crown, and then one time they came, and I said, why can't I get this for free? I mean, I give it out.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not the brightest guy, but I've had something to ask for. So they, yeah, cheers.
Got cheers.
Yeah.
Cheers, thank you.
You look good, too.
Yeah.
Wait, let me drink this first, and I'll. You do look great. You look
thank
great.
You. Likewise.
You do look great. You do look great.
Now, absolutely. I first of all,
that
I've
is
had.
Good.
I, yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't that nice? We can have another later.
I have a little cold, too, so help.
We'll go get a beer after the show.
Yeah.
You have time to grab a beer after the show?
No. No? But okay. We can do it sometime. We can do it sometime. We should hang out sometime. Yeah, no. I got to fly. I got to go see Leno. We
yeah.
Jay Leno.
I thought we were going to grab a quick beer after the show. Did you have fun on Leno last
night? I did.
Night?
We did one of the last shows.
How nice is that of Leno?
Jay, it's great. It was one of the coolest things to be invited on one of the last shows, and it's great to be on your last show.
Yeah.
So, yeah, no. That's not what I've heard. I mean, you just can't go from Cheech and Chong to fucking Carrot Top. I mean, I'm saying it's a bold move.
No, this is amazing. Yeah, no, well, no. But well, it's a real honor, isn't it? Yeah. He's always been a
Jay's
huge
been
fan
awesome
of yours.
To me for 22 years. I think I've done the show 31 or two. I forgot how many times I've done it. So he's been tremendously grateful to me. I've been grateful to him for my whole life. Funny, Tom, we were doing the show, and I said, as a joke, because Jay always flies back and forth. So this is a joke. We're getting makeup on. I said, Jay, I'm going to take your jet back to Vegas, just being stupid. And he's like, take the jet back, yeah. And I said, no, I'm just being funny. And he goes, no, I'm going back to Vegas tonight. Come. This is a good Leno, right?
Yeah.
Come back to go.
Yeah.
So I said, okay, I'm kidding, right? So I had I gave him my Southwest ticket and like $20 for gas. I was like, you know, just to cover the expenses of his jet. So we're flying in this private jet, like me, Jay Leno, and my assistant, whatever the hell.
Wow.
And we're flying, and all of a sudden, he's sleeping.
Uh-huh.
And it's just one of those surreal moments. You kind of look over, and there's Jay Leno just...
Yeah.
His head is this big. I mean, he's a big head. And he's just, he's got a mouth open. He's got his denim thing.
Uh-huh,
and thing.
Uh-huh.
But it was just one of those weird things, like, I'm in a fucking private jet with Jay Leno.
Yeah.
And the turbulence, all of a sudden, it's just the worst weather you could ever, as you know, going to Vegas sometimes, it's horrible. But this one was, like, really bad. And we're all holding on and jumping. All of a sudden, Jay just looks up, and I'm like, white in the holding on of the thing. And he's like, you know, the bump's bothering you? And I said, well, this is not good. And he says, yeah, it's not good. You know, if this plane crashes, the paper's going to say, Jay Leno dies with two unknowns. And I'm like, fuck you. I just did your show. Well, then again, I was on your show, so maybe no one watched it. But yeah. But it was funny how he just kind of just dug. I'm like, what? He's been very nice.
When you're hanging out with him off camera, is he just a regular guy?
Absolutely, yeah. He's been one of the nicest to me.
You have tons of these huge name celebrities come to your show at the Luxor, though. Because I've seen the photos in Vegas
because you get an eclectic group of people.
I've been
that come.
at the dog show.
The bounty hunter's there. Like, what the fuck?
No,
really?
But there are the photos.
He's there with his handcuffs and his guns. You're like, what the fuck? I wonder why people are bothering me. I'm like, well, you're dressed like you're going to kill. I mean, he literally tries to hide with his handcuffs and his brazen beads and his wife's tits around here. Why are people bothering us?
Him, too, but I remember a few weeks ago, Elton John showed up.
I went to Elton John's show. Okay. He didn't come to my show.
Because you texted
but he always
me,
says
you texted
gonna,
me the photo.
He always says he's going to come. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Nicolas Cage.
He's
is that getting, does that amaze you still, being a kid from Florida?
Once you meet, they're all just genuinely.
He's just normal now.
Normal people. Elton John was kind of cool, though. Yeah. You go backstage and he's like, hello, and he goes to kiss you, and you don't know if you should kiss him or should, like, literally, he went in for the thing, and I went, last minute, I went to hug, and I went, fuck it, it's Elton John. I go in. So it was one of those weird moments. Like, I just kissed Elton John, like a full-on mouth kiss. Yeah. And then my girlfriend's like, he didn't even hug me. I'm like, well,
got to take those opportunities.
Yeah, nice to see a character. I'm going to see him fist bump to her, you know. Yeah. Okay, but you got to take those moments. Yeah.
Let's take a call. Rick from California. You're on with Carrot Top. Go ahead with your question, Rick.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, good.
Hey, well, I was going to ask you,
What was my childhood like?
Yeah.
It was horrible. No, it was good. I came from a very, fun family. My dad was an engineer at NASA, worked at the Space Center. So growing up, it was, definitely not a showbiz background.
Your father worked on the Apollo
mission.
Worked
on the actual Apollo, and the shuttle program. So when I was a little kid, I never thought how cool of a job he had. Because you're little, you don't know. He's like, well, let's go to the Space Center. We're going to watch a launch, and we're going to go meet Neil Armstrong. And I was like, I just want to watch the Brady Bunch. In the green room or whatever. So I could care less. And then as I got older, I was like, oh my God, my dad worked on he trained the astronauts in the simulators.
Do you think that inspired you in any way?
I don't know. I always wondered if it did. People always ask me, like, your dad's background, do you think that has to do something with your creative process?
Seeing anything as possible, the sky's the limit, creative aspects of building
I don't think so. I mean, it might be. I don't know.
Is your brother an F-16 pilot?
And my brother's a pilot for, Air Force F-16. He's retired. He's flying for Southwest now.
Uh-huh. And so...
But, they can land anywhere.
So what do they...
This is your California. Is this Phoenix? They just land wherever they have... Did you hear about that? They landed in, like 20 miles from where they're supposed to land.
Yeah.
We can't do that. We can do that. We're comics. We can just say, oh, that was the wrong joke.
Whoops. That wasn't your brother, though, that did that.
No, it wasn't. I did call him right away. So that wasn't you, was it? I text him. I didn't call him that way. I text him that way. That's right.
Yeah. Now, do you think... What do they think in these sort of more serious...
I think they're all kind of shocked at the fact that, we're all growing up. No one would think that I would do what I do, and I was always shocked that my brother would do what he does, so yeah.
This is probably a question that you get asked, because this is one of those questions they ask, but it ties into his question. Was there something in your childhood that made you want to just get up in front of people?
Watching The Tonight Show back when, Johnny... And you see John Rickles and Jonathan Winters.
Yeah.
And I remember being a little, my mom tells me this now, I remember kind of briefly, but I begged to stay up to watch the comedians. And Johnny, I just liked that whole process of the jokes and the thing. And I wouldn't get the jokes, I just liked the fact that it was a guy getting laughs.
Yeah.
So, it was weird. I don't know. Definitely Jonathan Winters and those guys back
then. So you're in school.
And Don Rickles, I got to do a movie with Don Rickles, so that was pretty cool. And Betty White, so that was like a surreal moment where you're in a scene with Don Rickles and he's right there and he's giving you, shit.
So when you were in school, though, would you be acting out? Were you?
Yeah, I was always they always use the word class clown, but I wasn't the one that was necessarily causing a ruckus or getting in trouble. I was just the one that sat back and kind of made a joke or did, I wasn't,
but it wasn't
really in trouble.
Physical.
Yeah, I never got in trouble. I wasn't sent to the dean's office, but I was always the guy, oh, you're funny, you should,
Cool.
Yeah, it was fun.
Okay, we're gonna take a break.
Another one.
A lot more calls. Coming up with Carrot Top right after this.
Flying by.
We're back with Carrot Top, and we're going to look at some props. I want to ask you some details about how they work. I want you to show us some jokes. Let's take a quick call real fast. Yeah. We have Earl from Los Angeles.
Live from the Oakwood Apartments, it looks like.
Earl, go ahead with your question.
Yeah, after all these years, I was just wondering what your favorite part of being an entertainer is.
Oh, wow. You know, that's a good question. I think at the end of the day, just doing the show, I think at the end, if you have a good show, you know, after a good show, you're all happy and joyful, and you have drinks, and you have people come back, hey. So that part of the end of the day, when you make people laugh, or you get a nice letter from somebody that's gone through something horrible, and then you made them happy. I think the best part is just still doing this for a living is a great reward. And then the shows that the shows that you just have, everyone has them. You might not have ever had one. But yeah, those shows you're just like, oh my God, what did I do wrong? And you go home and you kind of overanalyze what you did.
Right.
Most of my friends who are comics are like, you got paid, didn't you? But that's not how I've ever felt about it.
You're very analytical about it. Do you go over the show bit by bit your head after the show, or do you?
If it's good, I don't. If it's bad, then I overanalyze, yeah. I never go back and watch or listen to it. It's horrendous. Even doing, like, when I watched the Tonight Show, it was good, so I kind of, just to make sure I look good, you know. But, or how it played, like, I'm sure a certain laugh might have been bigger or not, but yeah. By the way, I bought these jeans just for you.
Oh, green pants.
Green jeans.
Well, thank you.
We should do a show called Orange and Green.
Oh, yes.
Should we do another shot before we do process?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You were nice enough to bring.
I'm just thinking.
You were nice enough to bring all a bunch of your props, which
I want to ask you
questions about, about the props.
You
know, because normally it's just so rapid
fire. Hopefully I brought some good ones. That's kind of randomly. Oh, my God, Spock is on. All right. Cheers.
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 Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Great to have you here, Carrot Top. Let's have a look inside.
Yeah, let's see what we have. Let's see. This one's the one I talked about earlier. See, this is the Broncos helmets. They just came out. So see, it's stupid and silly, but right after it happens, the crowd will go nuts, you know?
So were you prepared for either team to lose?
It's funny you should say that. I did. I bought a Seahawks helmet and a Broncos helmet. Ready to go.
Yeah, cool.
And then I all of a sudden, when it happened, I drilled a hole, put the thing, and magic. This is one, like, I think this is like one of the old collegey ones.
Uh-huh.
It's a pillow if you're having sex with an ugly girl. It's got a built-in paper bag. That way you're like, hey, paper or plastic? Yeah, I know. But they love that. And then of course, the crowd, when they're sitting with, like, I'm fucking a hot chick, so I can't laugh at that. She's right here, so you can't pick on them. Not my girlfriend. This is this one is pretty good if I can get to it. This is the Miley Cyrus mixer right there. It's always a good one, classic. I mean, you can't go wrong with that.
Nice, no, yeah.
Yeah, you stick it right there, you just kind of
whatever
you need.
My gosh, yeah.
And that's it, right.
So let's break this one down. So this is made out of some foam core, a drill.
Yep. It took some engineering. If you notice, it has to be perfectly right.
Yeah, it's.
To give credit due, the prop builders at the Tonight Show made it for me, but I thought of it like right for the show. I was thinking I need a Miley Cyrus joke.
Well, that's brand new. That was made last night.
Yeah.
For the Tonight
Show. I said, can you give me a drill and a tongue and a face of her? And then I had all three parts, but I couldn't figure out a way to put. And the prop guy said, how about we make a little bracket?
Uh-huh.
And then put it all together at once, so I don't have to hold I was going to just hold the tongue through it.
Yeah, yeah. Nice.
So the Tonight Show gets half credit for having come up with a creative way to
nice.
Building that.
Nice, very nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
And Miley Cyrus,
Miley Cyrus' attorneys have already been in touch probably.
What else do we have in here?
Let's see what else we have. This goes on your kitchen counter, so you always remember to take your birth control pill. So that way you always know, if you see that, it's an extra reminder, like, oh, fuck, take the pill. I take the pill too, yeah. And that was, exactly. So that was probably, I'm trying to think how I thought of that one. I saw the little pill bottle first probably, and I thought, what's funny about taking pills every day? Oh, and then put the baby holding it, saying, oh, it's so silly. So, yeah.
Very good. Now, do you have every prop that you've ever made?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You
I
keep
have a
them
warehouse.
All.
It's not even a joke. There's thousands of props.
A warehouse?
I've been doing it since 1986, so I probably got... literally, it's the size of about half of this studio.
Yeah.
Full of
bigger than this warehouse.
But I can go through and kind of have it organized. So if I say a Clinton stuff, I had all the Clinton era stuff. So you know, or a part of something. So I need a briefcase and a rubber chicken. I can go find it and then put it together. But yeah, It's like a resting home of really of props.
Do you go back and pull out old ones and bring them into the show?
Yeah,
at the
sometimes. Yeah, I was putting up together for the show now called Carrot Classics. Because there's a lot of fans that have been that have seen my show, and then there's a lot of new people that have not seen that might not know my old stuff. So I thought we could say, hey, this is some of the stuff that got me here, you know. And so I go back and do some of the very early. So
first of all,
and make the trunk old so it looks like Carrot Classics is again.
Yeah, I can't say it enough. If I hadn't said it on the show already, it is the most hilarious show. Oh, I've been every time I come to Vegas, I come
you,
to the show.
You have been to the show,
and
many
you
times.
Always come out in the audience, and we do a shot of Crown Royal together in your show, which is hilarious and
best
fun.
Best part of the show.
Yeah, but it's awesome.
I came up with a way to do a shot. I just brought this big bucket down and made a big brown . Otherwise, it's just.
Can I just reach in and grab one and hand it to you?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Okay.
Just pull it from the bottom. Oh, I knew you were going to do that. I literally just going to say.
There we go. I'm breaking things.
This is a mouse trap to catch gay mice. See, that way. if it was a gay rat, it would go, hey, let's go to that party. Yeah. Okay. This one, by the way, this one. I think I forgot who it was. It was a comic that I like. I think Gary Shandling is someone that I really loved and respected. Said, I love that one. So it made me feel really good that he specifically liked the.
Okay.
Well. That's the Oscar for Brokeback Mountain. And I brought that just because the Oscars are next week. So I thought, hey, there's a classic. I want to thank the Academy.
It's award season.
Yeah, it's award season. So I thought that might be.
Cool. Okay. What? Well, this is interesting.
Oh, these are skinny jeans for fat guys. See that way. And this one's actually kind of clever. This is something if you actually put these on, it might actually. Work. That's one of those things where you actually would go, oh my God, you lose weight, you look good.
Yeah.
You look, it's leaning. That's just one of my t-shirts. Oh, that's a tampon box. It has a spinner. See, that way you say crazy bitch or regular bitch. That way you know what you're getting. Like, oh, crazy bitch. Yeah.
There's a rhythm to this too. I'm trying to keep
there's
the rhythm.
Going. You saw the show. Yeah. This is there's no rhythm now, but in the show
I'm
I have
trying to keep the rhythm
click.
Going.
Yeah. This is the Kardashians baby right there. This is a good little baby. Yeah. Oh, yeah, good baby. See, it's got a big. Okay.
Has there ever been a prop? Or
they're not all gems, by the way. There are ones that eat shit every night.
There hasn't. Yeah. Really?
Oh yeah.
Has there ever?
I always have belief in them because they're my children, but I build these things and I love each one of them. But there are ones that I will do religiously until they just don't work, and I'll do it for a long time.
You're trying to refine it, or
sometimes, as you know, with comedy, whether it's words or visuals, it's all in that one little thing. It could be a pause. It could be. Literally saying just one thing different, and it would all of a sudden you're like, oh my God, I've done this prop for 10 years. I just finally realized how to word it, whether it's too wordy or it's too. If I go to pick up something too, and I by a second drop it, doesn't get a laugh.
Right.
I've known that for years. Yeah.
Okay.
So there is a rhythm.
We'll get into it more.
We will.
Right
indeed.
After this. Stick around.
Don't go anywhere.
Back, we've got Josh from New York. Josh, go ahead with your question for Carrot Top.
Hey, what's up, Scotty boy?
Hi.
I want to know if an airline has ever lost your bags, and if you ever had to do a show without your props.
Yeah, indeed. Back in the day, there was a show we did at a college, and I got lucky. The airline finally did get it to me eventually, but we had to wait. Like it was like a 30-minute thing. Uh-huh. It was in a ice skating rink or something strange. It was already a weird gig. Like, what the hell am I doing in an ice skating rink? But they did. They did get it to me. But the only time it was really close call was doing that Regis and Kathy Lee show again. I go back to that because I did that a lot. I'm on a plane. I said to the flight, right when I got on flight time, I said, can you please make sure that my trunk gets on because I'm doing a TV show. It was that morning.
Yeah.
So it was like a 6 o'clock flight out of Charlotte. I remember this. And I'm on the plane. I don't know what made me look. I was just in the plane. I said, the flight attendant said, we got it covered. We're big fans. We'll watch. And all of a sudden, I look out the window, just casually look out the window. I swear my life. I look out the window, and I see my fucking trunk going on the plane next to me. So I really thought it was like a gag. Yeah, like they were like punking me.
Yeah.
So I look, and I'm like, oh, my God. Like, what the? And it's going. And so I went, oh, fuck. And I said, my trunk is. And so they come out, and are you sure? I said, it's fucking, it says flowers on it. It says Carrot Top. It's going on the plane next to us. Uh-huh. So they were like, we're already moving. We're already backing out. So I said, you have to be kidding me. I'm going live television in New York, and like, why don't we land? Mm-hmm. So the planes stopped.
Really?
Yep.
Wow.
And then everybody was wondering, like, we're stopping.
Yeah.
The pilot came out and said, hey, I'm a big fan. We'll go get it. And so he said, sorry, we had to wait for some luggage. And people were like, boo. And I sorry, my fucking trunk, sorry. Like, it was the worst.
Wow.
But thank
That's
God.
Amazing that
but
they
thank
were.
God I looked out. I was just like, da, 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 and but the best part was trying to explain that, no, it was mine.
Yeah.
It wasn't just.
It's nice to have that kind of power.
Yeah.
Right?
No, I was very lucky because when I lived there, they were fans.
Yeah. So that was a great question,
that
by
was
the
a
way.
Great question. And yes, it has happened. And it's horrible. Thank God this stuff made it today. What would I be doing right now?
Do you ever think of maybe going out and doing some stand up with no props?
Yes.
Now?
I have thought about that. I pitched it to Jay a long time ago.
Yeah.
I said, I want to do a propless set and come out with my trunk and never open it. And just do stand-up. And he said, that's not going to fly. He did. He said, no, you ain't a prop. I didn't care that without jokes.
He loves them, right?
He loves it. Yeah, he's always been a big fan.
He's so opposite of that in his comedy in a lot of ways. Do you think so? Or like, sometimes comedians look at
No, he's always been a fan. He always has been a big my biggest supporter, actually.
Yeah. Let's have a look at a clip from show at the Lux.
Oh, my show at the Lux. I was going to say,
yeah, we'll look at a clip from Swearnet after the break. But let's have a look at a clip of Carrot Top at the Luxor.
This better be good.
Here's a cookbook for you women that don't know how to cook and put the yellow pages in it. What do you want for dinner? Mexican? Japanese? It would work. It's a name tag for 7-Eleven employee. I got a lemon. Come on in. What is it? What is it? You gotta mail your taxes in, it's an envelope. Just walk right in the post office. You bastard, shit. This is the Hooters job application, right there. What do? Just fill it out and you're gonna. This is redneck air conditioning. Damn, it's hot as shit out there. I know, the whole show is stupid as shit. This is what I come up with. The best day in auto racing is Memorial Day weekend. You get two races back to back. You get the Indy 500 and then a NASCAR race. You got to watch it like back to back. It's like two different breeds of people. The Indy guy. What happened to your car? Well, the incinerator and the pump valve caused a malfunction in the combustion chamber. We had to shut it go down. It's quite disappointing the whole team. Try better next week. You watch NASCAR. What happened out there? Some bitch dumb blowed up. Fuck, I don't even know.
Let's have a party. I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best there's ever been. He played Found the Mountain, Run, Boy, Run.
It's
great. That was fun.
Yeah. The show is...
I look like I'm walking through it, didn't I?
Well,
I looked like I was just kind of walking through it. Hey, here's something. I got shit to do. I gotta go. I gotta go meet Nicolas Cage for a drink. I don't do this.
Was that a recent show or?
That was today in the afternoon. No. I don't know when that was. But it's funny. I almost wore that same fucking T-shirt. So thank God I didn't. I was gonna have my green C match my green jeans.
But there's a rhythm to it. We were talking.
There
about
is a
this.
Rhythm.
We've
to
talked
it,
about
yes.
this before.
Yeah, there's a rhythm.
There's a
method to the. Yeah.
It's a yes. fast-paced show.
It is a fast-paced show.
And there is lighting and video and music.
Well, it's Vegas. You got to kind of give that. You know, when I first started doing comedy, that was one of the things that people hated. Not people in general hated me, but when I did props in general, people were like prop comedy. But when I did the comedy clubs, I'd bring strobe lights and. Snow machines and fog machines, uh-huh. And they were like, "What is?" And I said, "I didn't want to do. I wasn't a stand. I wanted just to be a show, uh-huh. As opposed to just being doing stuff."
Vegas is obviously an ideal place because you're in one place.
Out.
The theater is a beautiful theater,
yeah.
And you have a whole crew that is running all these, all these sound clips.
Yeah, I have
and
a
video
great crew.
Clips.
They've been with me from day one. I have the same crew since day one. They've been with me for 20 years.
Yeah,
and so they know the show. More than I do, actually. And we change it every night. There's something new, they got to be on it, and they're great. And
you
the Luxor has been awesome for 8 years. I mean, two more running now.
8 years, two more
eight
years.
Eight years today.
Yeah,
and then we have two more there. And then, I don't know. Yeah, well, I hope we stay in Vegas. It's been fun.
You think you're ever going to have kids?
I don't know. Yeah.
Think you'll ever have some little baby carrots running around?
You want to have one? You want to have one with me? We could have a baby.
I was just wondering. Like,
I don't know. People always ask.
Baby carrots.
Yeah, baby carrots.
I was setting up for my baby carrots.
People always ask me that. I don't know. Yeah. Is my girlfriend here? She's probably not. How are we gonna have it? And she's not here. Yeah, we're not gonna have babies.
You have a girlfriend now?
She's here. She's stuck in. It's raining here in the traffic. This is a rerun. It's beautiful out today.
How long have you and your girlfriend been together?
We've been together for 5 years. Yeah.
Okay.
5 years. Yeah.
So
she has no idea what I do. No, she's good. Yeah. Yeah.
Cool. Okay, well, let's take a quick call before we go break.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, go ahead with a question for Carrot Top. Go ahead, sir. It's Jerry from Utah. Sorry, Jerry.
Hey, right on. Yeah. Access TV Live. You guys really are live. That's right on. Carrot Top, great props. I love the Kardashian baby. I just want to ask you, where do you get your inspiration for all these props?
Everyday life, yeah. Every day, every situation, we're comics, so you just kind of observe, watch the news, read things, and anything that happens in the news, it helps for us as far as keeping current, you know, Justin Bieber, great stuff.
Uh-huh.
You know, anytime there's a disaster,
I think
not necessarily a disaster in that regard, I mean, like Miley Cyrus or Justin Bieber or Britney Spears, it's like awesome.
Probably when you get
topical. The mayor from, you know, Jersey, like, yay, we get more jokes.
Right. So, yeah. When you get topical, it's probably that much
topical's
more surprising.
Fun. Yeah.
Because you...
The only problem with topical is, you know, you're a comic, is if you got to change it so often. So you have a shelf life of, you know, how long. But I would always go and you can always tell when it's time to give it up.
I like the Rubik's Cube gun control.
Yeah, I have that one here, yeah.
Yeah,
I that's like that. My solution to gun control. You just have a Rubik's Cube, so you got to be smart to shoot it. See, that way you can't. I would love to bust a cap in your ass, but I can't figure out a way to get this fucking gun to.
I was going to ask, you have a degree in marketing.
I do have a degree in marketing. I do, yeah.
Have you ever thought of or do you take any of these props, these inventions, and market them or sell them as a product?
We've been talking about that forever, about actually doing some stuff. Some of them that can be, that could be in a gag gift kind of stuff.
Remember the guy who made the foam brick?
Oh, I know, yeah.
And then that turned and he sold the 100 million.
The pet rock and all that, yeah. Snuggy. What the fuck? Why didn't I think of that?
Yeah.
Seriously, though.
Yeah.
A Snuggy.
For fuck's sake, the Snuggy. That could be a good one.
I mean, look at this. This is already better. This is a towel. It's a towel for nudists. I mean, it's already funnier.
That would be good. There's a lot of nudists. Okay, we'll be back. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Last act of the show coming up right after this. Stick around with Carrot Top. We're back. We're back. Okay.
Whoa.
Cheers. We're back with Carrot
Top. Yeah, we're not on. Are we on camera?
Yeah, we're back. We're live.
This is our seventh. This is a long break.
So we had a. We had a few.
Taking that with me.
We had a few good nights out drinking in Sault Ste. Marie.
Sault Ste. Marie.
Northern Ontario.
How cool is that? I love Canada. It's like a whole different country up there, really.
In a small little town in Northern Ontario.
Wasn't that fun, though?
Where we shot the Trailer Park Boys movie, Swearnet.
Remember the couple, though? The family that was out there the whole time? That was the fun. And you got them on your little thing.
I know.
Bang.
And I just thought about today. Like,
brilliant.
Really should have pulled that video for the show today. But
oh, my God. It was fun.
We'll put it up.
You can't even make it up. It was so brilliant, those people.
But we had an awesome time. And we had a fairly intense fight scene.
This is my
shot.
First time I've ever been in one of these. Remember, it took 2 days just to block it and rehearse it.
Yeah.
And then we actually got in there. I was pretty. You actually took a hit, didn't you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Or you hit him?
No, I hit him.
Hit him. Yeah, that's great.
Well, I called the Trailer Park Boys, amazing Canadian sensation, the Trailer Park Boys, friends of ours, and they actually sent us a clip from the unreleased movie Swearnet. So we're gonna watch that now, never before seen on TV from the new Trailer Park Boys movie. Let's roll the clip.
I'm excited for
you. Get shooting.
I didn't hear him say cut.
Fuck yeah, let's do it.
Stupid fuck, Darcy, there's a fucking race going on. Yeah, we're winning for fuck's sakes. Tom, I'm a big fan. I don't want to fucking hurt you. Should have had a rehearsal, man.
Holy shit, you fucking connected.
Fucking dead.
Oh, the bangers, it's for real.
No. You care? Oh, it's for real, Ginger.
It's not the hair.
Fuck.
Fuck, you want to play Swayze? Let's do it.
Fucking pussy!
Huh? Ah! Fucker! It's a real fucking fight between Tom Green,
Carrot Top, Rob Wells, and John Paul Jolie. This is the kind of shit you'll see on SwearNet.com. $5
Fuck
a month.
You. Come on, motherfucker. Let's see what you got. Fuck you. You wanna fuck with me? Fuck you.
Fucking bitch slap.
Fuck.
Seriously, was that crazy though?
Yeah. Now, there's no way.
You can't explain, right? Like, it was 2 days of filming that.
I don't think there's any way though that in real life we would ever have
beat them up.
Beat them up.
No. Those are brutal dudes. Yeah. That's the best part of Hollywood. Yeah. Like, yeah, I beat up those guys. Yeah.
Did you know the Trailer Park Boys before?
No. Oh, I met Bubbles. He came to the show, and that's how honestly how I got in the movie. He came back. He's friends with Axl Rose or something, and he was hanging out with him. And he just said, my crew, for maybe a month, we're on the road, we watched every episode and we were like addicted to it, like people are now with other shows. We were just like, oh my God, we knew every episode we're waiting for. So when he came to the show, it was literally like, we were like royalty. We're like, oh my God, Bubbles is here. And he came back, put the glasses on, did the whole thing, hung out with my crew. And I said, I'm a huge fan. He said, we're doing this movie. Do you want to be in it? You know how that is. Uh-huh. I'm like, yeah, sure, I'll be in the movie. And like, they're going to call you. And I mean, a month later, he sent me an email and said, here's the script if you want to be in it. And I remember reading it going, oh my God, this, like the first time in my life someone actually said, hey, I want to be in a movie, and they actually follow up with a real script and an invite.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So it worked out. It was great, yeah.
So you're going back to Vegas tonight. Show tomorrow night at the Luxor?
We're actually off tomorrow night, so we have a couple days off, and then
start back
on Sunday night. Yeah.
Sunday night.
So I have two more days to just relax.
And what night? Every night of the week? What night?
Yeah, this just happened to be a week off. We get a week off every once in a while, so it turned out.
So how many shows a year do you do?
I think 200 and something.
200. So basically, if you're in Las Vegas, virtually anytime, go to the Luxor, see Carrot Top.
Yeah, we're there.
It's amazing.
Thank you, Tom.
And, you know, it's been so great to have you here on the
show
today.
Likewise, and thanks for being a friend for all these years.
Yeah.
Good times.
Absolutely. Well, we'll go get a beer in a minute. Any last words? We have about maybe 15 seconds left.
Well, no, I just want to say thanks for all the years we haven't been friends for a short time.
It feels like a long time.
But it feels like forever, like this whole thing. No, it's been great. And you have a great studio and a great staff, and good luck with the show.
Thanks for doing
it.
Thanks, buddy. Awesome. Sure. Okay. Cheers. Good night, everybody.
Let's go get a beer.
See you next week.
Wait, I've got more stuff.
Next week with Sandra Bernhardt.
Sandra Bernhardt. Yeah. Oh, I love Sandra Bernhardt. Yeah.